In this lecture, we talk about not exact differential equations. So consider this differential equation like this, and this is not exact. What it means is that if you take the partial of this with respect to y and partial of this with respect to q, they are not equal. So in order to solve this, we will convert this equation into a exact differential equation. And you can do that by multiplying with an integrating factor. So say I of x, or another integrating factor, I of y. So this I of x is a function of x completely, and this I of y is function of y completely. And then you can solve the exact differential equation. So let us first compute what this I of x and I of y would be. So first step is, you just compute the difference delta between this partial and this partial. So obviously, if this was an exact differential equation, this delta would be 0. So what we want to do is, once we compute these I of y and I of x, you make the equation exact by multiplying throughout with I of x or I of y. So how do you make the equation exact? You multiply with I. So we can rewrite this equation in a differential form. So that is p dx plus q dy equals to 0. And then we multiply with I. We want this equation to be exact. So what we are trying to do, we are trying to compute these expressions I of x and I of y. So you multiply with I, you should get this differential equation, and this should be exact. So what does exactness mean? So exactness means that if you take the partial of this with respect to y and partial of this with respect to x, they should be equal. So that is what exactness means. So now you use the product rule. You have this, you product rule use here, you get this. Here you get this. Now this looks difficult to solve for I. So you make the simplest possible assumption. So first assumption you make is that, okay, my integrating function I is only a function of y. So this is only a function of y. So it should not have any x in the expression. And this assumption is important because this you need to check when you solve the problems. So this assumption one needs to keep in mind. So if it is only a function of y, you take its partial with respect to x, that would be 0. So that is, this term becomes 0. So if you plug this term as 0, this equation reduces to this equation here. So these two terms come right here, and this term comes right here. And then you transfer this term on this side, and this equation becomes like this, but instead of qx minus py, we use this delta right here, and now you use minus delta here. You get minus delta. Now you take this I, this here, you divide it, and you divide this side by p. So this is what you get. Now you put an integral on both sides, integrate it. So this will give you log of I of y. This is just this integral. Or now you get rid of the log by using exponential, and then you get I as a function of y, which is this. This is precisely the formula here. So therefore, when you're solving the problems, you need to check that this should be completely a function of y. There should be no x hanging around here because of our assumption right here. So we made a simplifying assumption that I of x is 0, and that's how you got this formula. You could have also made an assumption that I of y is 0 here. So that is, this part is 0. If this part is 0, again you copy this equation down here. This comes right here, and these two come right here. Again, you make the transfer. I'm keeping this ixq on this side and taking this to this side, taking I common. Then you have ixq, and this is precisely our delta here. So this is delta. Now you take I to this side, divide it through, and take q to this side. You get this. Now you put integration. Again, you integrate this side, you get log. To get rid of the log, you will use exponential, and you get this formula here. Again, when you get this formula for examples, you need to check that this is completely a function of x. So it's completely a function of x. Because we have made the simplifying assumption here that I of y is 0, and that forces us to say that I is a function of x only. So that is the only thing we need to check. And before you compute, you obviously should do delta over Q and delta over P to check which one is the simpler and which one would make sense if you integrate it. Because again, you want to get integrating factor as a function of X or as a function of Y. So this is how we derive these two formulas. And by definition, the way these have been defined, you get the exact differential equation, because we said that this equation holds, and then you did this. So let us see two examples. So the first example is the simple differential equation like this. Now first we check whether it is exact. So you say, you take the derivative of this. This is your P with respect to Y, you get 4XY. This is your Q, you take the derivative of this. With respect to X, you get 2XY. So both of them are not equal. So differential equation is not exact. So our first step is to compute delta. So you compute delta. So this is about PY minus Q sub X. And this gives you 2XY. So now we want a simpler of the two expressions. So first you either compute delta over P or delta over Q. But just looking at this 2XY, you know that the best thing to divide would be with 2XY squared. And that's what we do. You get 1 over Y and you get the integrating factor like this. Because you have to have this minus sign here, and that's why you put a minus here, because this is minus delta over P. That is it. So if you integrate this, you get minus log of Y, and this you can again rewrite it as log of 1 over Y. So this is your integral here. Now you put an exponential in front, exponential and log cancel out, you get 1 over Y. So once you have this integrating factor, so we have the integrating factor, you make the equation exact by multiplying throughout with I of X or I of Y. So we are going to multiply with I of Y. So you multiply it throughout. You take this 1 over Y and you multiply here. So you multiply here, you will get 2XY. You multiply here, you will get 1 plus X squared. And you can see this differential equation is exact, because now you have P and Q like this. And you take the derivative of P with respect to Y, you get 2X. And that is also the derivative of Q with respect to X. So partial with respect to Y, partial with respect to X. Now, to find the solution of this exact differential equation, you use method 3, which was discussed in class. So you rewrite on one side like this, other side like this. So this F sub X is this part, this partial is this part. So you integrate this 2xy with respect to x. What you get is x squared y, and then this variable here. This is just a function of y alone, because if you differentiate it with respect to x, you will get 0. Similarly here, you integrate this 1 plus x squared with respect to y, and you get y plus x squared y plus a function of x, because if you differentiate it, this will become 0, and if you differentiate this with respect to y, you again get 1 plus x squared. So now in this equation, you cancel these two out. So we are saying that g of y is precisely a function of y, so this is just this. And h of x, there's nothing else remaining, so h of x is 0. So you can take either left hand side or right hand side to do it. So if you take the left hand side, you get x squared y, g of y is y, which is equal to constant. If you take right hand side, again you will get y plus x squared y, and h of x is just 0, so this is also a constant. So this is our solution to the differential equation, and the differential equation is given to you right here. So our second example is given to us like this. So first step is always you check whether the differential equation is exact. So you take the partial of this with respect to y, you get y plus 2 exponential of x. You take the partial of this with respect to x, you just get exponential of x. So you know that this differential equation is not exact. So step one, right here, compute delta. So you compute delta, so you write py, and this is qx, taken from right here, and you get y plus exponential of x. Now looking at here, you know that this Q is sitting here and P is sitting here. So this Q looks simpler. So you have delta, which is this term comes over here, and you should divide by Q. You will just get 1. You take the integrating factor, exponential of x. So once you have the integrating factor, this one, I of x, you make the equation exact by multiplying with the exponential of x. So you take exponential of x and multiply throughout with this, you will get this, y squared by 2 exponential of x, 2y exponential of 2x, then this term. Now again, this is now our new p, and this is our new q. So now you can differentiate them and check that their partials are equal to each other. So that is, you take py and you take qx, they are going to be both the same. In fact, they are going to be equal to so y exponential of x plus twice exponential of 2x. So you can see from here directly, because you're differentiating with respect to x. And here also you can see, you first, the exponential of x is a constant if you're going to differentiate with respect to y. So derivative of y squared will give you 2y, 2 cancels out. This is how you get the first term. And again, when you differentiate the second term, exponential of 2x would be constant because you're differentiating with respect to y, and 2 will be also a constant, and this y will go away. You will get this. So this differential equation does become exact. So this first part we denote by f sub x, the second part we denote by f sub y, and we are going to solve it by method 3 as shown in class. So f is equal to integral of this part with respect to x, and here integral of this part with respect to y. So this, once you integrate this with respect to x, you will get this term here, and another expression g of y. If you integrate this with respect to y, you get this term here and this h of x here. This is just a function of x, because when you differentiate it, this should become 0 because you're differentiating with respect to the variable y. And similarly, this is only a function of x, because when you differentiate this with respect to x, this should become 0. So now we do the cancellations. This cancels with this, this cancels with this. So g of y is 0, h of x is 0. So you can take either of the two sides and then set it equals to constant. This gives you the solution of the differential equation, this.